Hello viewers, the present program discusses the characters, technique of narration, the significance of the title and themes of the novel The Dark Holds No Terrors by Shashi Deshpande. Let us first discuss the characters of the novel. We first come to the character of Saru. Saru is the female protagonist of the novel The Dark Holds No Terrors, around whom the entire story revolves. She belongs to a lower middle class family and thus has to face societal conventions, rules and regulations right from her childhood days. Though she is a normal child with simple desires and playfulness, but she is highly impressionable and is deeply influenced by the words and behavior of others. Saru displays a streak of rebellious attitude right from her childhood days. Saru does not understand the reason why her mother would not allow her to enter into the kitchen or the puja room during her menstrual cycle. Her defiance is seen in the manner she goes to the secret place in order to teach her mother a lesson for not giving her the permission to go for a movie with her friend. She also behaves in a rebellious manner by resolving to marry Manu for the simple reason that her parents didn't want her to marry Manu as he belonged to a low caste. A remarkable character trait of Saru is her determination as a student who aspires for high goals in life and works hard to see them come true. She works single-mindedly in her college to see that she becomes a doctor. She pursues her MBBS and even completes her MD within a matter of 2 years. She completes her specialization as well. She thus goes to prove that she is a person with indomitable strength and courage who has the passion and the determination to fulfill her ambitions. Saru displays sensitivity, which is extremely touching. She begins to feel guilty of having been an irresponsible wife, daughter, and mother. There is no denying the fact that Saru had been always accused by her mother for being the cause of her brother's death. Yet, Saru later realizes that it was her fault that she had abandoned her parents at a time when they might have needed her help and support in their old age. Similarly, later in the novel, Saru feels as if she was responsible for hurting her husband Manu's ego, again ignoring the fact that it was Manu who had been such a sadist who used to behave in a cruel and extremely savage manner with her in bed. Another dimension of Saru's sensitivity is that she is as sensitive to others' pains as she is to her own. Saru resolves that she would never become like her own mother, who was so unloving and unkind. She had resolved that she would be one of the most caring and loving mothers to her own children, Renuka and Abhijit. Saru is really hurt when Abhijit is asked to leave the birthday party of Renuka when he played a spoilsport. The title of the novel refers to Saru's predicament and the solution thereof. Saru, right from her childhood days, missed the warmth, love and understanding of her mother and thus tries to escape this darkness that symbolically stands for loneliness and a loveless existence. To escape this, she tries to marry Manu but finds no relief. Then she again goes back to her father's home but again fails. It is only when Saru realizes that she is complete unto herself and there is more to her life than being a wife, a daughter or a mother that she gets rid of the dark, that is her fear of a lonely and loveless existence. Let us now discuss the character of Manohar or Manu. Manohar or Manu is the husband of the female protagonist, Saru. Manu is shown to be a highly promising student of his college. He is not only a bright student academically, but is also actively involved in various co-curricular activities of the college. He is at once the secretary of the Literary Association of the college and is also involved in the activities of the Dramatic Society and Debating Union. He is also known as the budding writer of the college, all of which attracts students to him, particularly girl students. Manohar's sterling personality also attracts Saru in the college. Saru is irresistibly attracted towards Manohar while she sees him for the first time on the eve of the inauguration of the Literary Association of the college. Though Saru is single-minded in her pursuit of her dream to become a doctor, yet Manohar's magnetic charm distracts her to a certain extent. She wants to meet Manu every day. She begins to attend the rehearsals in which Manu would direct the play and would be mesmerized with his presence. During their courtship days, Manohar appears to be an ardent and passionate lover to Saru. He confesses to Saru that he is obsessed with her thoughts. He would write romantic pieces of poetry on her and would always meet her regularly. He also persuaded Saru to leave her parents' house and live with her in a room in a chawl. But it is as a husband that Manohar's love is tested and his true character can be analyzed. Saru and Manu's life is beset with many financial difficulties. Saru performs her duty as a doctor, but as for Manu, he does not do anything to solve these difficulties of the family. Instead, he places high demands on Saru, asking her to work as a doctor outside the home as well as perform her household duties to the fullest. And if she would fail to the slightest, he would make a lot of fuss. When Saru expresses her desire to give up her job as a doctor, he selfishly doesn't let her, saying that it was only her income that could be a source of comfort for the family. Furthermore, Manu is himself frustrated with his own life as he is unable to find a job. But he vents all his frustrations and disappointments of his life on Saru. He would sexually abuse her, behave extremely cruelly with her in nights, so much so that Saru's life becomes a hell. Let us now discuss the technique of narration of the novel. The story is narrated partly by Saru, the female protagonist of the novel, and partly by an omniscient narrator. However, there is no clear demarcation as to the parts that are narrated by Saru and those that are narrated by an omniscient narrator. The narration closely resembles the stream of consciousness technique, where much of the story is revealed through Saru's thoughts. The incidents are described as they occur in Saru's mind by way of association. For example, Saru, while being in her father's home, one day remembers the old days when her brother Dhruv would come to her being terrified of the dark to seek her care and protection. Saru is reminded of the incident while being at her father's home due to the power failure when the father's home is enveloped in darkness. Similarly, Saru is at her father's home, but she remembers how she would go to a temple and see a middle-aged woman who used to look absolutely normal, but all of a sudden would throw away the tray of puja and begin to gyrate. Saru is reminded of this lady when she thinks of Manu's dichotomous personality. As is true in the case of stream of consciousness technique, there is a constant shift in the novel as regards the time and space. For example, Saru remembers her adolescent days when she sees Madhav working on a garden patch in her father's home. She remembers that how her mother would always ask her to avoid roaming in the sun, lest she gets dark and it becomes difficult for them to get her married. There is also a constant shift in the space in the novel. For example, chapter 5 of part 3 begins with the description of Ganpati festivities in Saru's father's home. The scene then comes to the present and Saru is seen in her father's home. And then again, this scene shifts to the past and is now set in Manu's home, where Manu is shown speaking to Saru about his decision to start a magazine. Another very interesting feature of the technique of narration is the insertion of words in the middle of the text that reveal the innermost recesses of Saru's mind and heart. Saru is shown talking about a certain incident that had happened to her in the past, when all of a sudden there occurs in the text a line or two with words in the italics that speak about Saru's thoughts and emotions at that particular moment in the past. Thus, for example, Saru remembers despondently Manu's savage behavior with her in bed and speak to herself thus, quote, "No, don't. Talk to him now. Say something. Comfort him. Soothe him. Tell him it isn't important, that it doesn't matter." Unquote. We now come to the significance of the title of the novel. On the surface, the title of the novel, The Dark Holds No Terrors, simply relates to the fear of the protagonist's brother, Dhruv, who experiences as a child a fear of the darkness at night. Dhruv would be asked by his mother to sleep alone in his room, but being terrified of the dark, he would stealthily crawl out of his bed and go over to his sister Saru to seek her care and protection. But on a deeper level, the title of the novel applies to Saru's predicament and the solution thereof. Saru, right from her childhood days, had experienced immense hurt and pain at the hands of her mother, who abused her and called her the very cause of her brother's death. Saru would then feel extremely lonely and loveless. It is due to remove her fears of insecurity and lovelessness that she wanted to marry Manu. Once she marries Manu, she again was enveloped in a sort of darkness due to the emotional and psychological and even physical pain that Manu inflicted upon her. To escape this life that she called as nothing better than hell, she goes over to her father's home. Yet, at her father's home, she finds no relief. It is only when she understands that every human being is basically alone, and if she doesn't stand up for herself, she is sunk, that she is able to get rid of her fears. She comes to understand that all the terrors are within us all the time, and it is up to her to face those terrors and not to run away from them. Saru also comes to the realization that she has to accept the different aspects of her being, as a wife, as a daughter, and as a mother, as they are. And instead of beating her head about the faults that she has committed, she should accept all these selves and feel complete. Towards the end of the novel, Saru rushes to give medical aid to one of her neighbors. And at that point of time, what occupies her mind are just the thoughts that how she should best handle the medical emergency at hand, which signifies that Saru has now come to accept herself completely without any fear of the dark, that is, the need of support and love and care of somebody else, because now she is complete by herself. Let us now discuss the themes of the novel. Social prejudices. The novel reflects the prejudices that constitute the social fabric since ages and continue till the present day. We see in the novel how Saru's marriage with Manu is objected to by her parents, on the basis of the social bias. One, that Manu belongs to a low caste, and second, that it would be a love marriage. Another important social bias that has been dealt with in the novel is the deeply entrenched division of the roles of a man and a woman in the society. This is reflected in the question that the interviewer poses to Manu: how does it feel when your wife earns not only the butter but most of the bread as well? Her question reflects the social convention by which a man is required to move out of the home and earn the bread for the family, while the woman is expected to stay back at home and look after the family. Any other deviation from this norm would lead to questioning, as Manu had to face at the hands of the interviewer. Yet another social norm that has been dealt with in the novel is the subordinate position of a wife in relation to her husband. It is essential to preserve the male ego and thus maintain peace at home. Manu's ego is hurt to see that his wife is more accomplished and successful as a doctor. He makes Saru's life a hell to such an extent that Saru is compelled to think of leaving her job as a doctor and to be nothing else in life but Manu's wife. Status of women in the society is yet another vital theme of the novel. The novel reflects the status and role of women in the society through its two main characters, Saru and her mother. The life of Saru's mother is characterized by self-imposed silence and subjugation. She does not even speak about her illness to her family members that finally consumes her. Also, Saru's mother represents women who adhere to the age-old beliefs, superstitions, customs and traditions without ever questioning them. For example, Saru's mother would impose a large number of restrictions on Saru when she went through her menstrual cycle. Saru, on the other hand, represents the Indian woman who is gradually awakening to her rights as a human being. Saru resists the process of socialization at the hands of her mother right from her days of adolescence. She asserts herself and becomes a successful doctor on the basis of her perseverance and determination. To a certain extent, she also does not resign herself completely to a subordinate position in her marital life. But it is also true that Saru is any other new age woman who is always tormented by the thoughts of being an irresponsible and undutiful wife, mother, and daughter. Socialization of a girl child is another theme of the novel. The novel depicts the process of socialization of a girl child, wherein her thoughts, her desires, her way of talking, dressing up, sitting, eating, everything is regulated by the conventional norms of the society. We see in the novel how Saru's mother asks Saru not to move around in the sun, otherwise she would become dark and it would be difficult for them to get her married. At the onset of the menstrual cycle, Saru again has to face restrictions at the hands of her mother. She is not allowed to enter the kitchen or the puja room. Once again, when Saru decides to pursue medicine, her parents does not allow her, for the simple reason that her mother thinks that she is a liability or a responsibility to the family that should be done away with in the form of marriage. Therefore, we see that every step of her life, Saru faces restrictions and there is a curtailing of her freedom that inhibits her from being her true self and to fit constantly into the framework of the conventional attitudes, rules, and regulations of the society. Another crucial theme of the novel is individualism, wherein every individual has the right to one's freedom, dignity, and progress in life. This theme is exposed in the novel primarily through two characters, Saru and Madhav. Saru turns rebellious because her dignity is hurt by her mother's constant accusations that she is responsible for her brother Dhruv's death. Again, she turns a rebel and does not ask for her mother's permission when she decides to pursue medicine. Madhav is yet another character through whom the theme of individualism has been exposed in the novel. Madhav refuses to follow the footsteps of his father and become a priest. Instead, he aims at becoming an accountant, for he has a passion for numbers and finds the profession more financially rewarding. He refuses to go in search of his missing brother, for he thinks that that was the time when he should be preparing for his competitive examinations. His words, quote, "I can't spoil my life because of that boy. It's my life after all," unquote, strikes the keynote of the theme of individualism of the novel. Saru's rumination at the end of the novel that every human being on this earth is primarily alone and every human being has the right to work towards one's development echoes the theme of individualism of the novel. To summarize, the present program discusses the character of Saru and Manohar, the female and male protagonist, respectively, of the novel. It also describes the significance of the title of the novel that basically applies to Saru and her predicament in life. The program also dealt with the themes of the novel vis-a-vis social prejudices, socialization of a girl child, status of women in the society, and the theme of individualism. The program also discusses the technique of narration of the novel, which closely resembles the stream of consciousness technique. Hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you.